has been almost completely voided. Here's the vehicle in significantly blown up. Chassis ripped, the top's all gone. The little men, can't see any little men. The only way that that compressed gas could get out was by crushing its way through the roof of the bunker, with devastating effects on the contents of the bunker, which we see.
A bunker-busting warhead can penetrate about 100 feet into the earth and 20 feet into concrete. Now, there truly is no place to hide.
Once before, you could be fairly sure that if you were far enough behind your own lines and you were in a well-protected bunker, you didn't have to worry about being attacked by an individual aircraft. You felt fairly secure. Now, at any moment, a cruise missile can literally come through the window or come down the air duct and kill you.
The modern cruise missile has come a long way from its humble beginnings. But even the smartest weapon makes mistakes.
The Pentagon said this was a chemical and biological weapons plant. It looked, smelt, and appeared to be an innocent factory to produce baby milk formula.
Most cruise missiles rely blindly on intelligence data, which can be wrong.
The cruise missile, once you've taken the decision to launch it, then it might be a significant amount of time before it hits its target. You might want to change your mind. With most cruise missiles these days, you don't have that option. With a manned aircraft and a pilot, you can launch on a mission, and if the situation in the target area does not meet your brief, then you can not drop, you can come back, and you can go another day.
But there's a new kind of weapon on the scene. The futuristic cousin of the cruise missile, the unmanned aerial vehicle. UAVs are more accurate than cruise missiles, and they can come back. They can fly more than just one type of mission. The Predator, its skin covered in bulletproof Kevlar, its unusual shape making it nearly invisible to radar. Its cameras so sensitive that they can tell if a man on the ground is armed or not. The CIA uses it to take out snipers on rooftops or terrorists in their hideouts. Most amazingly, this Predator could patrol the deserts of Iraq, but be controlled via satellite link by a four-man crew sitting in an air-conditioned room in Las Vegas. The more dangerous the machines become, the more they need human guidance.